All right, chicos, poder. This is a very powerful verb. The reason I say powerful is because el poder, the noun, means power in Spanish. So there's the first gem for you. But poder, the verb, means to be able to. And I'm just going to rattle through some things which are super critical when we're dealing with poder. The first is the conjugation in the present tense. It's an irregular verb, as you can see here in pink. These are the irregularities. And it's what's known as a stem-changing verb, or a 1-2-3-6 verb, which I'll definitely need to make a video on. But the reason it's 1-2-3-6 is because 1, 2, 3, and then 6 are the only ones that change. So puedo, I can. Puedes, you can. Puede, he, she, it can. Podemos, we can. No, this is regular here. Podéis, you plural can, regular as well. And pueden, they can. So it's the stem changing here. Instead of the just keeping it P-O-D-E, it changes this to P-U-E. So that U-E is the trick in the present tense of poder. So screenshot this. You've just got to memorize it. And along that line is the preterite tense, so in the past. And it's irregular as well, the conjugation with the U here. So when we're thinking about poder in the preterite, I want you to think U, the letter, la U. And I want you to think no accents. You can't see any accents here. So pude, I could. Pudiste, you could. Pudo, he, she could. Pudimos, we could. Pudisteis, you plural could. Pudieron, they could. So again, screenshot this. You've just got to memorize it. Go through it. It will come naturally. Don't overthink it. We'll keep it simple. So let's have a look at a couple examples here. Then Mario puede cantar bien. Mario can, puede, the present tense here. He can sing, cantar bien. And you'll notice as well, another key thing with poder is it will usually be followed by an infinitive. So here the verb to sing. And you don't translate the two, it's just can sing, all right? And so another example of using the infinitive afterwards, but this time in the preterite, anoche no pude dormir. Anoche is a great word, it means last night. And that time indicator lets us know that we're going to use the preterite tense here. They're talking about yesterday in the past, last night. No pude, I couldn't dormir, to sleep. I couldn't sleep. You get rid of the two, all right? But you see the infinitive here. So infinitive is usually follows the verb poder. And I'm going to show you two more quick phrases with poder. And one of them is based off this great question by Ray, who wanted to know the difference between poder and poderse. So the SE on the end of a verb, that indicates that it's reflexive. And to be honest, Ray, with poderse, it's not really used much. The reflexive of poder is not really used. One super common example of it, though, is this. Sí, se puede. Yes, se puede. So this is reflexive here, and it really translates as to one can, okay? And it sounds quite formal and like posh English, but it's not. It's very common in Spanish. And it means se puede. It's like, yes, one can, you can. So here it's going to be, yes, you can. Or sometimes it will translate in more colloquial terms as, yes, we can. Sí, se puede. And you'll see it often as well used in a political environment. If someone's campaigning for something, it's, yes, we can. Sí, se puede. And don't forget the accent on the I here, chicos. That means it's yes. If you get rid of the accent, if you omit it, and it's just SI, that means if. So people will understand what you're trying to say, but just a little, that will take you to the next level if you remember that. And then the second phrase I want to show you, again, very popular, is sí, puede ser. And puede ser means, yeah, it could be. All right, ser, to be. And again, notice the infinitive following poder, and that means yes, could be. So the two very popular one, si se puede, or just se puede, means you can. Se puede cocinar aquí. Can one person, or can one cook here? Yes, si, se puede. Yes, you can. Yes, one can. And the second, si puede ser. Yeah, could be, possibly. All right. And so, if you want to know, by the way, why el agua is feminine but has the masculine el here, I've got a quick video on that, which is super helpful. And I hope you found this one useful. Please do let me know in the comments if you want me to cover anything else. If you have any questions, please do like this video and subscribe to the canal. It means a lot to me. It really helps out. And I also link my website to design work. So if you need any design work done, shoot me a message and we'll chat. Hasta luego, chicos. Un abrazo. Chao.